students, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to start a new chapter from your textbook, a very interesting chapter. Let's start this video with this meaningful quote. Kindness is a form of humanity. Yes, recently we have heard an incident which has happened in Kerala with an elephant. Elephant was killed by human beings. So children, here on the basis of this incident, we can get to know about that there is no humanity left in human beings. With this incident, we must have to learn having humanity is very, very necessary. It is good for ourselves as well as good for others. Now, the reason is to start this video with this quote because this quote completely relatable towards the story which I am going to start. The chapter which I am going to explain today, it is A Gift of Chappals. And the lesson has been written by Vasant Surya. And it is a true story. Here in this story, we have some important characters. Those are as follows. Mridu, it is the name of a young girl. Ravi, Meena, Lali, Lali. These three names are cousins of Mridu. Rukumani, aunt of Mridu. Pati, grandmother of Mridu. Beggar, who visited a character, this character who visited the house of Rukumani, Padu Mama, brother of Rukumani, and Masterji. Masterji comes to house of Rukumani to teach music to Lali. These are the important characters which comes in the lesson. Now children, before going to the next step of this video, I have something to inform you. Today onwards, I am going to take attendance of yours. Yes, I am going to take attendance because I am not getting the right views for my videos. For example, 7th grade complete strength is 75. Is it more than 75, 76 or 77? So those many views I am not getting. So what I decided now, today onwards, for this video onwards, your work is to, when you will sit to watch the video, your work is to go into the comment section and then there you are typing your name. For example, Yamini, present ma'am. For example, Nikhat, present ma'am. Or Aishwarya, present ma'am. Or else XYZ, present ma'am. Your name is must and should required. 24 hours after uploading the video of mine into my YouTube channel, after 24 hours, I'll see the attendance of yours. I'll see all the names. Whoever will not watching this video, whoever will be not watching this video, what I'll do, after 24 hours, I'll call the parents and I'll speak to you also. Soon after 24 hours, I'll wait for 24 hours, then I'll call personally to the child who is missed here. Yes, so your work is to watch every video very sincerely. Now, let's move for the next step of the video. Here children, you can see on screen new words, list of new words, and also take the textbook in your hand and also pencil as well as textbook in your hand. Take it and sit to watch the video. These are the list of new words which you are supposed to write in your textbook with the pencil. And as you know that the lesson is very big, so we have lots of difficult words, which I have listed out in this video with their meaning. Almost all I covered it. If any word left, then children, you yourself, you do that exercise. This is also new words list. You can take the screenshot, children. It will be easy for you to note it down. Now let's move for the part of explanation. This is the first page of lesson, and the chapter which we are going to study is A Gift of Chappals. Before starting explanation or reading paragraph, let's read the before you read. Here, Mridu is a young girl growing up in Madras. Now the Madras is called as Chennai, with Tapi, her grandmother, and Tata, her grandfather. One afternoon, Tapi takes her to her aunt Rukumani house to meet her cousins Lali, Ravi, and Meena. Children, here the story is all about Mridu, who lives with her grandparents in Madras. Nowadays it is called as Chennai. And one day her grandmother took her to the house of aunt. The name of the aunt is Rukumani, to meet her cousins. And the name of the cousins are Lali, Ravi, and Meena. This is the information of the story. Now let's start the first part explanation by reading paragraph by paragraph. Smiling Rukumani threw open the door. Ravi and Meena rushed out, and Ravi pulled Mridu into the house. "Wait, let me take off my slippers," protested Mridu. She set them out neatly near a pair of large black ones. Those were grey, actually with dust. You could see the clear mark of every toe on the front part of each slipper. The marks for the two big toes were long and scrawny. Children, in the first para, Mridu went to the house of Rukumani. When they reached the house, then with the smiling face, her aunt opened the door, and all the cousins, especially Meena and Ravi, ran towards the door and they started to pull the Mridu. But Mridu protested. Here she said, "Okay, wait, let me open my slippers." She defense here, protested in a sense, defense. And when she was setting her slippers near the door, she has observed one pair of shoes, large black ones, pair of shoes, which were in color of gray, and it was too old as well as dusty. When she was setting out her slippers, that time she observed this one. And you can see the, and as I said you, it is old pair of shoes. So easily you can, in our slippers also, if we are using it constantly for long time, then we will get the marks of our toes, is it? So there also it was present. And next, Mridu did not have much time to wonder about whose slippers they were, because Ravi dragged her to the backyard, behind a thick bitter berry bush. There inside, a torn football lined with sacking and filled with sand, lay a very small kitten lapping up milk from a coconut half shell. Children, here in the second para, when she protested to the Ravi to wait, and when she was setting the slippers of hers near the door, that time after setting out it, Ravi did not wait for a minute also, did not wait for second also. He pulled her towards the backyard of house, not in the house. They went out of the house, backside of the house, where they were having lot of trees, a kind of a garden, small garden. There, when she visit there, there she has seen a football. You can see football, torn football, children, which was punctured. You can understand, you can take it as like this, punctured football, On that punctured football, there was a small kitten sitting and lapping and drinking the milk from the coconut half shell. So children, Ravi and Meena hide there a kitten, and the kitten was drinking the milk from the coconut shell, and Pati don't know about it. We found him outside the gate this morning. He was mewing and mewing. Poor thing, said. And Meena, it's a secret. Amma says Pati will live for our Paddu Mama's house if she knows we have a cat. Yes. When they dragged her towards backyard of the house, she has seen a very small kitten which was drinking milk from the coconut, half coconut shell. And Meena said here, we found, who said this one? Meena said that we found it outside of our gate morning, and it was poor and it was very hungry, and the cat was shouting because of her hungriness. And she said she added here one more thing, that it is a secret. Amma says that, Amma knows about it. Amma says that if Pati is going to know about it, then she will leave it in the house of Paddu Mama. So that's why we are not revealing to her. That's why we dragged you here. Now, people are always telling us to be kind to animals. But when we are, they scream, oh, don't bring that dirty creature here, said Ravi. Do you know how hard it is just to get a little milk from the kitchen? Pati saw me with a glass in my hand just now. I told her, I am very hungry. I want to drink it. But the way she looked at me, I had to drink most of it to throw her off the scent. Then she wanted the tumbler back. Pati, Pati, I'll wash it myself. Why should I put you to trouble? I told her. Then I had to run and pour the milk into the coconut shell, and then run back and wash the tumbler and put it back before she got really suspicious. Now we have to think of some other way to feed Mahindram. Children, when they were saying the secret of kitten to the Mridu, then Ravi said here, he added here, Mridu, people will always teach us to be too kind with the animal. But when we will try like that, when we will be doing that one, then they will shout us, they'll scream on us. Why like this it is? They will scream. They will say, why are you bringing, why are you touching the dirty things? It is true, children. It is actually true. The lines of Ravi are very true here. And one more thing he said here, Mridu, do you know how hard it is to keep this secret from Pati and how to feed him? Just one more, first example, when I went to take the milk for this kitten, Pati has seen me. She has seen me. Then what she came and she started to ask the questions to me. Then what I did, I said to her, yeah, I am taking this milk for myself. And because of this secret, I drank the milk. And she was hurrying to take the tumbler in a sense glass. She was hurrying to take the tumbler back. Then I said, don't take trouble of because of me. I'll wash you. Go, Pati. He convinced the Pati. When she turned very fastly, he ran towards the kitten, that coconut half shell, and he poured the milk, and again he kept back that tumbler after washing it. This is the words of Ravi. Now, and also he added here, Now it's time to find another way to feed the Mahindram. Here there is a one word. What is that? Mahindram. Mahindran. Mahindran, it is a name which has been given by Ravi to the kitten. Yes. Mahindran. This is little kitty's name, is Mahindran. Mridu was impressed. It was a real name, not just a cute kitty cat name. Mridu, when she heard the name of the cat, then she was very impressed with the name. And Ravi added here, it is not a common, it is not a cute name which has been given by me. It is a real name of a cat. Now she is in little bit confusion. Actually, his full name is Mahindra Varma Pallava Pune. Children, the name of the kitten is, according to Ravi, Mahindra Varma Pallava Pune. MP Pune for short, if you like. He is a fine breed of cat. Just look at this fur, like a lion's mane. And you know what the emblem of the ancient Pallava kings was, don't you? He looked expectantly at Mridu. Children, now here you can see the very wonderful character of Ravi. Ravi was a character who speaks little bit more than reality. Here he is doing the same thing. Can you believe the name of the cat will be a Mahindra Varma Pallava Pune? No, not at all possible. And also he is saying in this lesson that it is a breed of it has come with the generation of the Pallavas, king Pallavas. And you too know the symbol, emblem is a symbol of the Pallava in ancient. And he was saying lot of things to the Mridu. Now when Mridu heard this lines from Ravi, she started to giggle. She started to laugh slowly. Think, I am joking? Well, just wait. I'll show you something. Sometime. It's clear you don't know a thing about history. Haven't been to Mahabalipuram, have you? He said mysteriously. Well, when our class went to Mahabalipuram, I saw a statue of his tatas, etc., etc., etc. Fact is, Mahindran here is a descended from that very same ancient cat. Children, when Mridu started to laugh on the words of Ravi, he got angry and he said, don't think I am joking with you. It is true. It is reality. You don't know about history. Have you ever been Mahabalipuram? And he started to add more words to his words of more than reality. And he said that I have been to Mahabalipuram when my class went for trip there. I saw there one statue. The statue belongs to whom, children? The lords of tatas of this kitten. Yeah. He said here, tatas, many tatas, generation. He is just trying to convey the generation breed of the cat. Next, a close relative, scientifically speaking, of none other than the lion. The Pallava went on, walking around the bitter berry bush, waving a twig up and down, his eyes sparkling. This cat is a descendant of none other than the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. And if I may just remind you, they worshipped cats in ancient Egypt. And again he started to say his words, say his imagination. You can take it as the imagination of Ravi. He started, you know, this cat belongs to God Rishi cat, Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. And it is a beard of Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. And also this Rishi cat has been worshipped cats in ancient Egypt. Next, how he loved the sound of his own voice. When he was saying this one, the cat, the kitten was moving towards here to there. It drank the milk then it took a twig. The word has been used here, twig. It started to move from here to there. It was playing around the berry trees. How he loved the sound of his own voice, Meena and Mridu exchanging looks. What does that have to do with anything? Mridu demanded. Oh, I am telling you, this cat is descended from Egypt, cat god. No goddess bestowed. Yeah, that's it. When Ravi was saying these all the words, the cat belongs to descendant of the Egypt worshipped god, Egyptian worship god, this that and all. That time, Mridu and Meena were changing their looks. She is not at all believing the words, as well as Meena also not believing the words of Ravi. But he was angry and he was saying that whatever I am saying here, this cat belongs to descendant of the Egyptian god cat, and this is the true, and that's it. I don't want to explain too much to you. Now, well, one of the descendants of that cat goddess was a stowaway in one of the Pallava ships, and his descendant was the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat, whose descendant is Ravi, flourished his twig at Mahindram, MP Punai here. Hoop eek, he shrieked, very pleased with himself. He was taking the bush of berry tree in his finger, and he was just rounding it, and he was talking by doing this one towards the with the Mridu. Then he started to say one more thing here: whatever I am saying, that is truth. And his imagination is wonderful, children. Here you can observe this one. You can notice very clearly the imagination of Ravi is very beautiful towards the history of Egypt as well as the Mahabalipuram Pallavas. Here what he said, it is one of the descend of that cat goddess. It is one of the child which has come from the goddess of cat, and it moved towards the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. Then the same cat comes out from the Rishi cat of Mahabalipuram. So this Mahindran is also the worshipped child of that goddess cat. And he was pleased with his words itself. Mahindran looked up, alarmed. He had just been sharpening his claws on the edge of the coconut shell. But worse than Ravi's awful hope, eek was a creech. From the window, what a weird sound. If Mridu was startled, MP Punai was frightened out of his wits, hair standing on end. He bounced up and skewered towards a bamboo tray of red chilies that had been set out to dry. Trying to hide beneath it, he tipped a few chilies over himself. Meow, he hooted miserably. Children, when Ravi was speaking these all the things, his imagination, sharing his imagination with Mridu, that time suddenly they had heard the sound, very weird sound of sound from window. And before hearing the sound, this very cute kitten stood up and started to scratch the coconut shell. As you can also know, you can notice it. You are noticing it. Why? Because many of you people are taking care cats in your house. When this cat also heard the sound, very screeching sound, then it stood up and it was frightened. When it was in weird shocking zone, then what cats will do? The complete fur will be standing. Yeah, because of the frightenedness. Then it moves. It has taken a leap, jump from that football to the bamboo which was used here to dry some red chilies. There it was jumped and it covers the some red chilies on it and started to shout. And it was sad at that time, frightened. The creature went on and on. "What's that noise?" said Mridu. When Mridu heard that continuous screeching sound, then she asked to Ravi, "What is that? From where it is coming?" "That's Lali learning to play the violin," grunted Ravi. "Yes," then Ravi replied, "Oh, it is the sound of Lali who is learning the violin from Masterji. She will never learn a thing. The music master just goes on playing like a train, whizzing on and on, while Lali's all the time drilling, going completely out of track." And Ravi said here, she will never play to learn. I know that. Simply he comes and he will teach to her. And he will play that violin very beautifully, very melodiously, very nicely, like a train is moving on correct track. And when Lali started to play, then it will be going out of track. The sound comes like that. Yeah, this is the complete explanation of the first part of lesson. I hope children you have understood it. And if any doubts you have, you can ask me by sending a message or else you can call me. Now children, once again I'll remind you, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And today onwards, as I said you before itself, I am going to take attendance. Once again I am repeating it, I will take the attendance of yours. Compulsory attendance is compulsory here, with your name, and by typing your name you are saying present ma'am in the comment section, each and everybody. I'll wait for 24 hours, then personally for each child I'll call after 24 hours. Thank you so much children for watching the video. Goodbye. Take care of yourself.